So if you click on the flex can, or this thing, this window flex can underscore one window will come up, and in this you will be able to see different headers, name, config time support, flex can configuration, flex can general, flex can timeout configuration, and the flex can PN configurations. Now this is the view and this is the section where we'll be configuring all of our flex can peripheral. There are different sections in it, different names and the different subsections through which we'll be able to configure according to the flex can features that it offers. Flex can general will be containing the enablement of the APIs, like the enablement of the certain features, and on enabling these features, a macro guarded would be there, and those functions, the APIs functions, would be accessible to us. Out of all these, the only thing on which we are gonna make changes, the flex can configurations. Rest all the things we are gonna relay as by default for the motive and the areas which we are covering in this course. Now coming to the flex can configuration, so here you can see a plus cross sign and a number section. Okay, and over here there you can see number of subsections. So first of all, understand from this. So flex can hardware channel, as I have told that in the SL2 K144 there are three channels, three instances. So number of MB stands for number of mailboxes that we want to use. So maximum we can set 32 mailboxes, okay, and minimum we can set zero mailboxes. Not zero, it is by the default of one, okay, like the indexing. So maximum, okay. FlexScan RX FIFO filter number. It is like if we will enable legacy RX FIFO. So if we will enable the RX FIFO mechanism, so this section will become active, and in this we can configure how many FIFO message ID filter tables we want. As we are using standard or the extended FlexScan only, so in that case only 8 size of payloads can be done. If we change payload size, so it is going to show an error because we have not enabled the FDCAN, because only more than 8 bytes of data are only available in the case of FlexScan FD. Okay, so 8 is the payload size. Now what is the RxP4 filter type? What is the type of mechanism that you want to use? We will be doing the flex scan according to RxP4 mechanism. If we uncheck on it, so we are going to use the flex scan according to the mailbox configuration and the mechanism only. So okay, so this is the difference. Yeah, okay, before that, flex scan protocol clock. What is the clock frequency that is going to be input to the flex scan peripheral? So that we are gonna set at 48,000, in which it will be storing the macros, the structures, and the functions according to the configuration which I have done over here. Okay, so now let's just click on the update code and go and click on the okay. Once you go and click on the okay, so your update code is gonna happen. Okay, so in the generate include folder, it will be storing the .h files that are generated for according to our configurations. That is, it will be storing all the macros and the structure definitions and the those function definitions. Okay, number of different instances, the contents according to the FlexScan peripheral. Okay, so we are gonna understood about these things in the code section. For now, you guys, I guess, must have understood how to use the GUI of this FlexScan. What are all the different names and the meanings of the different sections? Okay, and yeah, important thing one more to tell on this. If I plus on this, so I can have a one more configuration